My name is Rocco Orbisi, a friend, colleague of George Carlin, producer, director of his last 10 HBO specials. I actually knew George before I even worked with him. I actually met George before I even was in the business. I came out here, went to the studios, and we wound up at a Tonight Show. George happened to be on the show. And I saw him in the hallway, and I approached him, introduced myself, and he said, "What are you doing?" I said, "Well, I want to come out to California one day, but I wrote a piece of material called Captain Catholic." He was amused. And he said, "What is Captain Catholic?" Captain Catholic is a hero. He has a cape and a mask and the color of the Vatican. He's got CC on his chest. It's a kid's show. It's Captain Catholic time. It's Captain Catholic time. Captain comes to you. Be good and God bless you. Captain Catholic, boom, boom, boom. Out comes you in this cape and you do the genuflection and exercises. And then you have products to sell, which is spray and pray holy water. And Captain Catholic cereal, which is just hosts. And he said, "Stop." He says, "Stop." He says, "First of all, I love this. It probably will never get on television. But when you come out to California, contact me." I was 23, 24, whatever I was. And I came out, and I was working on the last Steve Allen show. And I started booking George. So I kind of struck up a relationship with George, and then booked him on the Midnight Special. And then I hadn't seen him for a while. And I'm driving down Sunset. This is 84, 85, I can't quite remember. And it said George Carlin at the Wadsworth. And I bought a ticket. And I went to see the show, and I went backstage. And he was happy to see me. He pulled me out in the hallway. He said, "You want to do my next HBO special?" And I said, "Be honored." And I did 10 in a row. And I never thought I would do 2 or 3. I get a call from Jerry. "We're doing a show called, it's going to be called Jammin' in New York. It's going to be called Back in Town. What am I doing in New Jersey?" That was all, the title was always there. It was never a surprise. And they never changed. This is the only time it changed for obvious reasons. I loved the title, kind of like When a Lot of People Die. Because I couldn't wait. You know, with a title like that, you can't wait. My first instinct was obvious. It's going to be about people that we, you know, that suck, that we're glad they're dead. But then I said, "Nah, he's not going to do that. He's not going to do that." We had pretty much fixed what we were going to do. And me and Bruce Ryan had trying to design some kind of set. And what's interesting is the graveyard set that wound up with And Life is Worth Losing, the one in the Beacon, was the one we were going to use on People Die. So that was thrown out immediately when the horrific news came about 9/11. I thought they were going to cancel the special at first. I really did. But then when he called me up, "We're changing the title. I guess we're going to have to change the title." I didn't find out till later it was going to be called Complaints and Grievances. And Bruce and I didn't have time to conceive a set for that. So we did the construction pipes, you know, in New York, when they're having construction, you walk in, and that great poster. And we put it as billboards, and we kind of put the set together at last minute. That show, to me, will always be special because of that event. But then after a while, when George walked on stage, it was another HBO special. And we all kicked in gear. The audience was great. I think they were looking for some relief. I think they were grateful that he came. We were kind of in this fog. And I remember it not being a joyful experience, but I think it was a grateful experience. Hey, look, he's from New York. It's his hometown. They fucked on his turf. Maybe people didn't understand at the time, but it's pretty historic that a major figure would have the balls to do a comedy special this close to a horrific event, make it funny, entertaining, and political. You know, I think that's incredible. But that's George. It's just amazing to me now when I hear it after the longest time. What an incredible piece this is. It really is. It's right up there, boy. And what a beautiful message at the end. I remember that very clearly. We miss this guy, don't we?